Hi everyone, I'm Rani Osnat from Aqua Security, and welcome to this first installment of Working From Home, or WFH, with Aqua. This will be a series of very short conversations we're going to have about working from home, Aqua's business, how we're doing. We're not going to speculate about COVID-19 or predict various predictions. We'll leave that to the experts, and even they don't know what they're doing. So, I'm happy to have with us today Dror Davidoff, our CEO and co-founder. Hi, Dror.
Hi, Rani. Good to be here.
Happy to speak to you and see you, if not in person, at least on video. So, you know, we've been working from home for about 2 weeks now at Aqua. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, one of the first things we want to understand is, you know, where is cloud native going? How does this affect cloud native? Has anything changed in the market? What do we think?
Yeah, that's a very good question. I guess, you know, among many other questions we have open in our mind. But, you know, before this virus spread started, we all understood that the transition into the cloud and into cloud native have crossed the point of no return. It was very obvious for all organizations that they will be moving to the cloud if they haven't so far, but more than that, they will have to go cloud native to really take advantage of all the new technologies and opportunities around the transition to the cloud. So from that respect, I think the trend will continue. In some areas, we will see a slowdown, obviously, because of the, you know, global economy slowdown. But on the other hand, I think for many businesses, this will actually be part of the strategy out, you know, the way to rebound out of the situation, to accelerate the transition into the cloud, and hence accelerate the adoption of cloud native technologies. So, you know, we will see a mixed picture. Again, you know, there's a lot of unknown, but I think there is no doubt the trend will just keep going, and in some areas will just accelerate.
Yeah, and in fact, you know, we couldn't imagine our lives in this situation today if we didn't have Zoom, which we're using right now, and WhatsApp, and Teams, and Netflix, and, you know.
All that just proved that, you know, those services are essential for the modern world. And I think more and more businesses that were, you know, taking their time in their transition, still sticking to their old traditional way of doing business, this will be an immense boost for them to move forward. And also a lot of the, you know, consumer habit, B2B habits will change in such a way that will just accelerate trends into the cloud, into cloud native, into doing business in a very, very different way. Cloud native opened a lot of interesting opportunities for businesses to actually not only do cost efficiencies or adopt new technologies for certain functionality. It's much more than that. It's about a business opportunity to transform your business, leveraging technology for that. So I think we will see much more of that in the coming years. And this time, very special time, will just be an accelerator to this trend.
And we see resilience as well, right? I mean, if you have these capabilities, you can adapt to various situations a lot faster. The fact that none of these services that I mentioned before collapsed with a peak in demand is a testament to how resilient this technology is.
That's absolutely true. And that's also an excellent proof of how powerful is the idea of shared resources. You know, if any one company had to build capacity for a situation like this, she would never be able to do that. But using shared resources over the cloud, while, you know, they have, you know, the might of the public cloud, they can very easily, and I think Zoom is one of the best examples, right? They can very easily scale up, and of course, having a very good technology that can actually do that. That's a very interesting combination. And like I said, the world will not be the same after we come out of this, you know, difficult situation we're in.
And what about security? Where does that fit in?
Well, security, good question. So, you know, traditionally, when you look at, or historically, when you look at other points where there were slowness in the economy, where there were, you know, any kind of a difficult time in the economy, you know, cyber threats are just increasing. So we can assume that this will be the situation now. You know, many of those hackers, you know, bad guys sitting at home now and just trying to find ways. On the other hand, people's defenses are down, right? they are consuming so much more services online and their defenses are down. So we can see an increase in phishing attempts. We can see increase in all kinds of, you know, more sophisticated attacks. So we can assume that we will see more of that. And since we're moving to the cloud, people will have to at the same time to invest in securing their cloud infrastructure to secure their cloud native environments. So again, I think that, you know, although there, you know, there is a slowness in the market, those two areas will keep moving forward, and in some extent will just accelerate. So the need to security will just accelerate in those times.
Yep, and I think if anyone thought naively that the bad guys will sit back on this one and say the world is in a crisis, the world is in a crisis, we'll take pity on those people. No, it's not happening. We already see.
On the contrary, they take advantage of that. They take
advantage. Exactly. Okay, Dror, thanks a lot. We have a whole day in front of us. We have a whole day ahead of us here. See you on the next one.
By the way, I thought that, you know, you should call this series a Zoomcast.
It's a Zoomcast. Yes. I don't think Zoom shares need any more boosting from us, but yes.
But you know, great technology. So thank you very much. Good to be here, and stay safe. Stay home.